a full battery charge in just 17 minutes, an unprecedented performance and feature pack within its class. So, is Xiaomi 11T Pro the best 2021 value flagship? Let's inspect! Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Michael and this is Tech for All, where we inspect a lot of cool tech like this brand new smartphone, and let us get rid of this protective case because right now we don't need it. So that's Xiaomi 11T Pro, my kind of daily driver for the past couple of weeks. I say kind of daily driver because I've been using it parallelly with the Mi 11 Ultra, so I can say a lot of things about this smartphone already and my big lists about the good but also about the not so good things. Disclaimer, I got the unit for free by Xiaomi, but nothing in this video has been sponsored, reviewed or edited or advised by them, so it's my own genuine thoughts, and I hope we can keep up the conversation in the comment section below the video where you can tell me what you think about this phone. Now, few words about its existence. As you probably know, Xiaomi release at the beginning of each year their major line, and then in the second half of the year they bring the T series, which are featuring most of the great features, however some slightly downgraded components and maybe some new awesome innovations. And obviously this year the focus is on hypercharging. We're going to talk about this in just a moment. I think the series are super attractive because you can buy a great flagship at a very good value, and I guess this is exactly the line which annoys a lot of the Samsung and OnePlus fanboys. They probably kind of belong to the latter group still. But the fact is that for €650 or dollars, you know, this is loaded with amazingly great features. And I think the only comparable type of device that is being released lately is probably the Galaxy FE, but it's still unclear what they have to offer this year. So let's dive into it. First things first, unboxing and getting to know what's this fuss all about. There's nothing too unusual about this unboxing, maybe except the weight of the box. It's quite heavy indeed. So for some papers, a protective transparent silicon case, nice to see it's coming for free, the phone, lovely, a flat screen, nice to see such one these days. I can see the Harman Kardon logo at the bottom, this means quality sound coming from the speakers. The color of mine is called Meteorite Grey and I like it a lot. But you know what? There's almost an elephant inside the box. Yeah, the heaviest smartphone charger I've ever seen. The 120 watt beast indeed. I know that Samsung fans are probably gonna hate me for saying this, but on the left you see a phone which charges to full for more than 1 hour and 17 minutes. The one on the right charges from zero to full within just 17. For the record, the twice more expensive S21 Ultra, despite being slow as snail about charging, comes without a charging brick in the box. And no, I'm not paid to praise the Xiaomi 11T Pro. The last few statements are pure facts, and I underline that there are a lot of great reasons to favor the S21 Ultra over other smartphones, however the charging part is obviously not one of them. Since we're on the spec sheet topic, let me quickly cover the most interesting ones. Snapdragon 888 with its octa-core processor, the great Ardeno GPU which comes with it, and the fantastic X60 modem for 5G connectivity, LPDDR5 and UFS 3.1, 8 or 12 gigs of RAM, 128 or 256 gigs of storage, vapor chamber cooling, 120Hz AMOLED screen, triple camera setup, all the latest connectivity features, the mentioned unicorn battery with 5000mAh capacity, and if you're not that much into specs, there's hardly anything to not like about the phone. Extremely fast RAM and storage, the best-in-class Snapdragon processor this year, 108MP main camera, well, if you prefer in-display fingerprint scanners, this one ain't such, it's embedded in the power button. Call it a tradition for the T-series. But really, the ultra highlight is the battery. It supports the so-called rapid charge, which can charge the dual-cell battery to full in just 17 minutes. Because all of that sounds really scary, and probably some of you remember that a few years ago there have been a bunch of smartphones from another brand that were exploding because of battery issues. Well, here Xiaomi took the time to implement 34 battery charging safety protections. And also they've passed the TÜV Rheinland fast charging certification, and they claim that after more than 800 recharging cycles with a 120-watt charger, the battery is going to maintain above 80% of its full capacity, something I can obviously not confirm at this point because the phone is too new. The other big advantage is that the battery has very good temperature tolerance, and even at minus 10 degrees Celsius, charging is possible and it's gonna work fine. So now if you wonder how this phone can give us so much for 650 bucks and Mi 11 Ultra costs like twice more, let's take a closer look at the camera. Before anything else I say, the camera is good, almost great, kind of Redmi Note 10 Pro performance, same main image sensor, better AI and processing, better aperture and glass, no optical image stabilization, however the processing applied by the camera app is amazing and the phone produces really fantastic photos. For daylight photography, pretty much no comment needed because it's true flagship grade quality. I almost never had to retake a photo twice. For night photography, however, you may need some more patience, but you can still get some fabulous results. Almost everything about the performance is solid, except for the areas where optical image stabilization comes handy, like zoom-in photos, or low-light video, or night video mode, or 8K. There also is an ultra-wide image sensor, quality of this one is also good, and the camera app also has this dedicated night mode for this camera. And last out of the three sensors, a telemacro, which I can already praise for its macro photography capabilities. It can focus a distance of just 3 centimeters, a 5 megapixel sensor, so there will be enough data in the photo to prefer the super macro mode over a cropped image from the main sensor. In terms of video, I was actually delighted by the amount of details, very balanced footage with awesome characteristics. I've even used part of it during the Xiaomi 11 Lite 5G NE video, something that we can easily mistake with mirrorless camera grade quality. The video resolution goes up to 8K, which is of course super crisp and detailed. However, you better use a gimbal if you shoot in 8K because it's not stabilized. Hopping on to the journey covering the rest, amazing performance. Snapdragon 888 is usually a bit warmer than most other chips, but the vapor chamber cooling here does a great job to keep it cool and avoid slowdowns during gaming. I've tried a lot of cool games for rather long time, most of them were really heavy. The phone never got too warm and I haven't experienced dropped frames or slowdowns. Needless to say that counting on a high refresh rate display is a fantastic opportunity to enjoy premium level of gameplay. Important to know that the screen is protected by Gorilla Glass Victus, which is the toughest one up to date, and the same one is used with the Mi 11 Ultra. Inside, we have huge amount of RAM and the performance is obviously great and also among the fastest storage solutions in the industry, UFS 3.1. And they say a lot of good things about the sound from the stereo speakers tuned by Harman Kardon. Just hear it out. Just a reminder, last year's Mi 10T Pro was awarded as the best smartphone for quality sound, so I guess Xiaomi would love to see the same grade of success with the 11T series. The rest of the highlights are also cool, the iconic and traditional for Xiaomi devices infrared blaster. You can use your phone instead of most remote controllers at home. There's the integrated in the power button fingerprint sensor, precise and quick. Always on screen modes, 360-degree ambient light sensor, and if I've missed something cool or not so cool, feel free to add up in the comments below. If you wonder what are my takes on the hardware-related drawbacks, no optical image stabilization, no Type-C to 3.5mm audio included in the box, and no wireless charging, although 17 minutes to full with a wire, you can't beat that right now. As for software, MIUI 12.5, based on the latest Android, out of the box, and the battery life is great too. Xiaomi 11T Pro is going to offer great standby times and really decent screen on time. If you're searching for a flagship with amazing battery, the combination between fast charging speeds and the excellent standby times of the latest MIUI versions is just great. The rest may feel familiar, especially if you've had a Xiaomi made phone before. A lot of customizations, the really unique themes engine, a lot of tweaks and helpful apps for great productivity, and the usual amount of bloatware, which you can easily get rid of by using the MIUI debloater tool that I'm going to link in the description below this video. Other than that, Xiaomi are pushing the new style of the control center. I still prefer the old one. This goes far too much in direction iOS for my taste. Zero crashes, glitches or issues I've had in terms of software. I've seen some harsh comments about the state of MIUI in the past months. But as a heavy MIUI user in the past months, I have nothing to complain about, especially after discovering the ACR dialer, which is very close to the good functionalities I miss from the MIUI dialer. At the end, this phone has true flagship DNA. And now it's your turn to let me know which are the features that you like the most and you probably dislike the most or probably miss the most. Would you miss wireless charging or just 70 minutes to full? It's just about right. Because yes, that's the fastest charging in the industry given the competition at the moment. And for $650 with the charger included inside the box, well, there's no surprise that Xiaomi are considered to be the smartphone maker with the largest market share right now. And I do believe we've just reviewed the best value flagship of 2021. So thank you very much for watching this episode, and I hope it's been useful. As you may guess, some battles on the horizon, so just pick a device you want me to test against the Xiaomi 11T Pro, and I'll see what I can do. Please support the channel, would be great if you become a subscriber, hit the like button if you feel it's well deserved, and I'm Michael, gonna see you very, very soon. Bye!